Love you.
Hello, Olivia and Hans. My life verse is John 3:16. For God so loved the world, He gave His only Son, so that whoever believes in Him will not perish but have an eternal life. Maybe I should, you know, I know that verse so well, and sometimes I sing it. Maybe I should put a melody on it. For God so loved the world, He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish and have eternal life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save.
That is appetizing to the flesh.
And I know very well how it feels like to go off that righteous path. And our God is a great God, but if you disappoint Him, He hits hard. In Tagalog, palo. And that hurts. And it can hurt you financially, it can hurt you relationship-wise, in any aspect in your life that you thought you were happy in. Yeah, it's scary. But if you follow on His righteous path, everything that you had in your heart, your most bizarre desires, is going to be granted not only one, but more than 100-fold. And I can say I am a witness to that great power that our God has. Thank you.
So, hello everyone, good evening. I'm Jesse Perkins, Christian Perkins. And I think our one shared life verse was going to be 1 John 4:19. We love because Jesus first loved us. But since there are two of us, I'll say one of my personal favorite life verses, which is Romans 8:28, which is, and we know that all things work together for good to those who love the Lord and who are called according to His purpose. And I think that's a beautiful verse because it shows that no matter what happens in life, if you feel disappointed, if you feel like, oh, this was supposed to go another way, just wanted to encourage everyone here that God's plan is the best plan, and even if you don't understand it, all things will be beautiful in this time, and all things will work together for good. And I think that was important for my brother and I. In studies, if we didn't achieve what we really wanted to achieve, or sports, God had a plan, and through failures or even through expectations that were not met, He can make beautiful things out of that. So that was encouraging for me growing up, and it's still encouraging to this day. Hopefully, it encourages everyone here too. So thank you.
Yeah, so my favorite verse is, it's actually two, Veterans Connected. It's Mark 12:30-31, and that's the most important commandment, to love the Lord our God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. And the second is to love your neighbor as yourself. And it's important, first of all, obviously, because Jesus said that's the most important commandment, that we're supposed to love the God with everything we have, with all of our heart, with all of our soul, with all of our mind, with all of our strength, that means with everything we have. So for me, for my brother and I, that's how we live our life. We want to love God with everything we have and give Him all the glory, and also to love one another, to share that love.
Verses Matthew 17:20. It says, Jesus said, "Truly I say, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you." And I hold steadfast to that verse because when I was 21, I was born and raised in Seattle, Washington. God knocked on my door to take care of my 85-year-old grandmother in 2011. And I was 21 then, and I said to myself, "Lord, how can I take care of an 85-year-old woman by myself in the Philippines? And I'm culture shocked, I don't know anyone. I barely had any friends starting here. But look what God can do." Look, 7 years later, until the day she died last January, 25, she was my rock and my center. And I tell everyone here who is around my age, love your parents, but love your grandparents also even more. Because when you honor them, God will bless you abundantly in ways you can't imagine. Let Him lead you, and let Him be the light on your path.
Thank you.
Take the right time.